Yes, crabs are safe to consume as long as they are cooked.
Hi everyone, welcome back to Ask Me Doctor Weekly Q&A. I am Hazel from motherhood.com.my. Our topic for today is how to eat appropriately for two. Does it sound familiar to you? I want to stay healthy, but people are telling me to eat more. Or, I don't know, I just wanna eat it. Get advice on what to eat and how to eat appropriately from Dr. Timothy, obstetrician and gynecologist from Tongshin Hospital and Samway Medical Center Velocity. We'll answer the top 10 questions that you submitted on our Facebook and Instagram. Hi Dr. Timothy, how are you?
Hi Hazel. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Timothy from Tongshin Hospital.
Let's start with number 10. When is the right time for me to take extra calories? Is it in the first trimester or after that?
You need about 1,800 calories per day in the first trimester, 2,200 calories per day in the second trimester, and 2,400 calories per day during the third trimester.
Is preeclampsia common among pregnant women?
Preeclampsia is an eating disorder during pregnancy. This is a condition where the woman practices extreme dieting and is constantly exercising as she's concerned regarding her weight rather than her health. This condition can lead to malnutrition and it can also put risk to the baby in the form of growth retardation, low birth weight, as well as birth defects.
Is it normal to experience nausea during the first trimester?
Nausea is common in the first trimester. It is caused by the increasing hormone levels during the first few weeks of pregnancy.
Number 7. Are artificial sweeteners okay during pregnancy?
Artificial sweeteners that are safe in pregnancy are stevia, aspartame, and sucralose. Saccharin and cyclamate should be avoided.
Is eating for two really a thing? Should I double up my portion in order to get sufficient nutrients for both me and my baby? Can being too full hurt the baby?
Eating for two is a myth. If you double your food portion, you may end up consuming excessive calories. This will not help with your weight control. You do need increased intake of certain nutrients, vitamins and minerals, but this is in the right balance. Being too full can lead to discomfort, indigestion, heartburn, nausea and vomiting.
Now my next question is on food craving. Does it happen to all pregnant women? How do I manage food craving?
Food cravings are common in pregnancy and they tend to peak in the second trimester. You can consume food that you crave as long as it is not something harmful. Do remember to eat in moderation and consider healthy alternatives.
Since food craving during pregnancy are normal, if you have a sudden urge for a certain food, go ahead and indulge it if it provides you energy and essential nutrients. Now next, how much caffeine consumption is allowed during pregnancy?
Caffeine intake should be limited to 200 micrograms per day. A general rule is not more than a cup of coffee or tea a day. Caffeine can also be found in soft drinks and energy drinks.
Number 3, is it fine to be on diet during pregnancy, like practicing intermittent fasting?
If weight gain is a concern, you should consume a healthy and balanced diet. Stay away from excess calories and sugars instead of dieting or skipping meals. Prolonged intermittent fasting in pregnancy may lead to low birth weight babies.
Number 2, can I eat seafood during pregnancy? I heard that we should be eating more fish. What are fish that we can eat and what are those that we should avoid?
Seafood like fish and shellfish are a good source of protein, iron and zinc. Fish is also a rich source of DHA which promotes baby's brain development. Beware of large predatory fish like sharks, swordfish, king mackerel and tilefish as they can contain high levels of mercury. Safer choices are salmon, anchovies, sardines, canned tuna, shrimps, tilapia and Pacific mackerel. Make sure that you cook your seafood thoroughly and avoid eating raw seafood. Yes, crabs are safe to consume as long as they are cooked.
Now for our last questions, what are supplements that pregnant women should take during their pregnancy?
Women are recommended to take at least 400 micrograms folic acid a day prior to conception until 12 weeks of pregnancy. Folic acid prevents neural tube defect in babies. Vitamin D is important to both pregnant and lactating mothers as it helps regulate calcium and phosphate in the body. Iron is essential in preventing anemia. Calcium is vital for babies' bones and teeth. However, be cautious about excessive vitamin A as it can be harmful to the baby. You may consider taking prenatal supplements, which are multivitamins formulated to meet your pregnancy needs.
For all of you who are experiencing the joy of welcoming two or more babies in your family, we're very excited for you. Stay healthy by eating a well-balanced diet and make sure you're getting plenty of water and sleep. We wish you happy and safe pregnancy with a healthy and joyous baby. Thank you, GetDog and Dr. Timothy for answering our questions today. Sign up for GetDog Plus for RM3 a month or RM36 a year so that you can enjoy concessionary rates and make your appointment before your consultation with Dr. Timothy. Stay tuned for our next weekly Q&A. We'll cover topics on the common illness such as HPV, cervical cancer and ovarian cysts. Remember to submit your questions before Thursday so and stand a chance to win free 2 years of subscription of GetDog Plus and RM10 motherhood.com.my voucher. And also receive a free ParentCraft kit worth RM75 when you sign up Motherhood ParentCraft Class for only RM50. Thank you and see you again in the next episode.